wasn't that big a deal. It only happened once. Nobody really cares about me. They just want to mess with my body.
I don't understand why he did that to me.
I was afraid to tell. I didn't think anyone would believe me.
I've been feeling real afraid and having bad dreams.
My name is Marilyn Vanderbrattler. I'm a former Miss America and an incest survivor. When I was 5, my father started coming into my bedroom late at night. The sexual violations continued until I was 18. Every day and every night of my life have been dramatically impacted by incest. When I was 46, I went to my first group support meeting. I was stunned that half of the women there had been sexually violated as children by older teenagers so many years ago. In the past 2 years, I've spoken in 125 cities. I've met and talked with thousands of survivors. A high percentage of men and women in pain have said to me, when I was 8 and my brother was 14, or when I was 10 and my female babysitter was 15, I believe nothing would have stopped my father. But I also believe that most teenagers just don't understand the lifetime of pain that can be caused by what too many people refer to as sexual experimentation, or kids will be kids. That's why I wanted to produce this film. If you have been sexually violated, I'm so very sorry. If you are ever tempted to violate another child, I hope that after viewing this film, you will understand that even one violation can cause a lifetime of pain.
When I was 12 years old, my mother sent my two older brothers and I away to a home for boys. My father had died 5 years earlier, and my mother couldn't take care of us anymore because of her health. It didn't take long for the other kids to figure out that I was weak and vulnerable. One of the other kids cornered me one day and attempted to have sex with me. When he began to touch me, I got scared and I ran away. Because I talked to some other kids about what happened, he started a rumor that I was a queer. Shortly after that, another kid my age, but a lot bigger than I was, blackmailed me and raped me, threatening to beat up my brothers if I told. For the next few months, this happened over and over. I was terrified. I tried to tell the head counselor as best I could what was happening, but he blamed me and said it was my own fault. I was really ashamed and didn't want to tell my brothers or my mother. I felt like I had nobody to help me or protect me.
My name is Sandy, and when I was 9 years old, I was taken into a large shed by 3 teenage boys. 2 of them stood back and watched as the 3rd one raped me. My life has never been the same since that day. Before the assault, I was a pretty happy kid. I spent a lot of time outside playing. And afterwards, I was in fear, and I was afraid to go outside. And so my life became pretty lonely. I felt guilty because I didn't run away from them. And I felt bad, and I felt like I deserved what happened to me.
My name is Sharon, and I was raped when I was 15 by 2 neighborhood boys, ages 14 and 15. I couldn't ever tell my family, friends, or anyone about the rape. One day after school, I called one of the guys next door to borrow something. When he came over with another friend, I really didn't think about it. After a few minutes, the conversation switched from TV to sex, which I wasn't comfortable with at all. I tried to change the subject, but the guys became physically aggressive and I became angry. Things escalated and I told them to leave. Instead, they grabbed me and pinned me down, and both boys raped me, and I fought the whole time. When they finally left, the younger boy, who I had a long-standing rivalry with, informed me that I had just been put in my place. One day in December, I began to feel something was wrong with me while at school. I didn't know what was happening, and I began to have intense labor pains at home that evening. I finally had to tell my mother that I needed to go to the hospital, and after 19 hours of labor, I delivered a baby boy who was taken from me immediately and put up for adoption. I have suffered with depression and physical problems all of my adult life, in large part related to that day. You can't think that there are no consequences for what happens among kids. There are severe and long-lasting consequences, internally and externally. No one gets away without scars.
All children need to be safe, need to be taken care of, respected, and loved in order to be healthy. Their lives can be devastated if someone bigger, stronger, or more powerful uses them or takes advantage of them sexually. If this happens, a child may begin hurting others as a way of getting his own needs met. We want you to understand what we mean when we talk about sexual abuse and what can be traumatizing to children and teens. Touching, just touching, a child's sexual or private parts. Ridiculing or teasing a child about their body or private parts. Showing a child a movie about sexual contact. Including a child in nudity or sexual behavior for a movie. Having a child pose for nude or sexual photographs. Anything involving a child's body, their private parts, or sexual activity that has to do with a more powerful person getting their needs, sexual interests, or desires met. That could mean kissing a child in a lingering or sexual way, sexually stimulating themselves with the child or in front of a child, or any physical contact with their body or private parts and your body. A lot of people don't realize how much harm can be done. They may not understand how serious sexually abusing someone can be. We hope that if we can help you to understand this, you won't pass on this kind of pain to another child. Nobody deserves to be treated that way. Not you, and not me.
My name is Neil. I'm 8 years old. I was abused by a kid that lives in my neighborhood. He is bigger than me, and he is 9. He would come over to my house, and after he did, we would play Super because he likes Super, and he only has a Nintendo. And so when we play, if I would win a game, then he would touch me in my private parts.
When I was 14, I was raped by my older brother. He is 4 years older than me. I grew up in an upper middle class household in an exclusive neighborhood of New York City. My father is a distinguished doctor, and my mother is active in community affairs. We look like the perfect family on the outside, and I'm not sure when I told my parents. It might have even been a year later. I finally got up the courage to tell them about the incest. And they said it was no big deal. They said all children play sex games. What happened to you is normal. And they told me that I was really lucky to have an older brother like him. And then my father said to me that he couldn't help me stop the behavior, that I had to tell my brother to stop. And he refused to understand that I couldn't stop him, and I couldn't really tell him how badly I hurt. I felt such shame over the incest. I thought I must have been a really bad person to begin with, to have a family that treated me that way. And I felt like I didn't deserve any better.
My name is Eric. I am 24 years old. I was repeatedly molested by a male babysitter at the age 4. I felt so guilty after he abused me. I felt like it was my fault. I didn't tell anyone because I was scared that I had done something wrong. That people wouldn't like me for what had happened. I think it is hard for guys to talk about being sexually abused because if you were quote unquote a real man, you would have been able to protect yourself.
My name is Jan. I was abused by a 14-year-old when I was 11. It was all so new to me. He touched me in places that I didn't know I had, and He said things to me that I didn't understand, and he laid on top of me, which made no sense to me. But he liked me, and I had something that no one else had, special attention. Later in school, I learned about sex and came to realize that I had been used and taken advantage of. Looking back on this as an adult, I'm very sad. I'm sad because of what happened to me and how it affected my life. I had no idea how much of an effect sexual abuse has on a child.
My name is Danny. I was sexually abused by a neighborhood teenager when I was 6 years old. That was my first sexual experience. At 6 years old, I was forced to participate in sexual acts that I had no understanding of, and I was terrified. Many of these acts continued to be forced on me over the next several months. He told me not to tell anyone, because if I did, my parents would leave me. I no longer felt like a child, and my life was changed.
Being sexually abused makes a kid feel worthless. If someone can treat them that way and make them feel horrible and embarrassed and ashamed, then they feel like they must not be a very good person. Most children feel that the abuse was their fault. They really don't understand what happened, and they can carry that self-blame in their minds for years. They can go through life feeling that they are bad and worthless, and then it's easy for people to continue to take advantage of them and treat them badly.
I can remember a time in my life after age 12 when I didn't have some form of destructive behavior. The reason I felt so helpless is a broken spirit. When I was a little girl, I was shown that I didn't matter, that everyone had power over me, and that I couldn't win. When I was 12, I was raped by my 18-year-old brother. For some reason, we were alone at home, and I saw him come out of his room naked, and I joked about it. The next thing I remember, I was on his bed, and he was on top of me, and I didn't know what was happening. But I was scared it was very wrong. Other things that didn't feel good had happened with men before, but now it was my own brother. Before that, I always acted shy and withdrawn because if I did anything wrong, I would get hit or slapped in the face. But since the rape, I really went into a fantasy world. I just wanted to be alone and daydream, because I knew I really could not trust anybody. I started failing almost every subject in school after being at the top of my class, and I flunked every year until I finished high school. I wasn't interested in anything. I didn't finish anything. I felt different from my friends, and I was not really close to anyone. Many times, I really wanted to die. I never even thought of telling anybody about the rape because I was sure I would have been blamed for it. I felt everyone believed I did everything wrong, and I was screamed at or punished if I tried to tell my side. Now I know why, at 17, I left Europe by myself and never moved back.
My little 12-year-old self couldn't handle all this overwhelming pain. I couldn't stand the humiliation, so I found a new reality, one that I could control. I began to think it was somehow my idea to start being sexual at 11. It was no longer an experience, it was a tool to get what I wanted. Love, power, control, escape, love. I continued this destructive pattern through adolescence and into adulthood. I would use a tool to meet my needs, then withdraw into innocence and purity when I hated myself so much I couldn't even look in the mirror And the cycle would continue. Starved for affection, I would again use my body.
Sometimes what can happen with all that guilt and shame is that they can start treating themselves like they aren't worth very much. They might drink alcohol, do drugs, eat excessively, or stop eating altogether. They may use these substances to avoid these negative feelings. Some may lose all respect for themselves and others, and may start doing dangerous things like committing crimes or hurting themselves or hurting others. Most people who have been abused as kids don't believe they deserve anything good in their lives. They don't deserve respect, they don't deserve love, and their bodies aren't important. They feel that they are no longer private and no longer theirs.
I didn't tell anyone anything when something happened, or I felt that I was at fault. I felt that it was my fault, and I felt that there wasn't anyone that I could tell. There wasn't anyone that was going to believe me. Because actually, I guess I didn't believe it myself. I felt that I should have been able to do something. I don't think that there's anything in my life that hasn't been affected by it. Obviously, I have an eating disorder. My self-esteem fluctuates from believing that I can do anything to being completely unsure of myself. It made me an underachiever.
I became scared of going outside. I knew it wasn't safe out there. I stayed indoors and watched TV, read, and ate. I ate a lot. I got lost in the lives of characters on TV and in books. I tried to deal with my abuser in creative ways that a child would think of. I drew many pictures of ugly monsters and horrible demons. Those creatures really existed in my world. One even lived on my block. I retreated into myself where no one could hurt me. I grew into a loner that revealed as little as possible about myself, and that is something that has stuck with me throughout my whole life.
A few months after I was raped, I started drinking. I started stealing alcohol out of my father's liquor cabinet. And within a few years, I drank as often as I could. And then by the time I was 16, I drank every day for the next 13 years.
Some children who are abused are threatened not to tell anyone what happened. They might be told that they, or a pet, or someone they care about, will be hurt or killed if they tell. Or they might be told that people will think that they are bad and blame them for what has happened. Children become so frightened by the abusive experiences and the threats that they usually hide all their feelings inside themselves. These children may never shed a tear, scream out in fear or pain, or even tell their best friends what has happened to them. It is even possible for a child to be so overwhelmed that they will completely forget or block out of their minds everything that has just happened to them.
I guess the way that I lived with that and coped with that, what they were doing to me, was to just forget it. For years and years. And now that I remember what they did to me, I remember the physical pain and the fear. And the anger, and the confusion. I feel like it was my fault that I had done something wrong. And I guess that's part of the confusion now, is wondering what I did to cause that to happen. I know too up here that it's not my fault that I didn't do anything wrong, that they had no right to do that to me. One of my cousins was always saying he was going to go do scary things to me, sexual things, and I didn't know what that meant. I only knew that I was just really scared and didn't want it to happen. It was really uncomfortable. And then he would say, if I told anyone that he would do this to my mother and sister.
I can remember the day that I was raped. The boy just spoke to me in such an angry voice. And he kept telling me what to do. Turn this way, take this off, don't look at me, close your eyes, don't say anything. And he just kept repeating over and over again, if you tell anybody about this, they're gonna know how bad you are. And my mother was so strict, and all of us kids had to be so good, that I just knew that he was right, that I was bad.
Sometimes kids have hurtful experiences in their own families, or with people that are close to them. There may be some adults in their lives who humiliate them or take advantage of them sexually in some way. When that happens, that kid can feel so bad inside that they may want to go out and hurt another kid to make them feel better or stronger or less vulnerable, even if they end up feeling bad about it later on. Kids and adults are the same in that regard, in that they don't like feeling bad inside. So sometimes they try to make other people feel bad and hope that will make them feel better. That's not a good way to deal with the pain. They really don't get rid of the way they feel, and they devastated someone else's life in the process.
And I don't remember what I was thinking or feeling one day when I was 14 years old. I don't remember having a sense of anything. It was just no feelings, like I was a robot. And I took my 7-year-old brother by the hand and I led him into a field where nobody could see us. And I remember the urgency in my voice as I was telling him to do the things to me that my cousins had done. And I don't even remember. I mean, I don't even know what I wanted him to do or what it meant. He had to do that to me. And then I remember looking at his face. And I seen in his face all the things that I had felt, the shame and the fear. And the confusion, he had such a puzzled look on his face. And it was just like this wave of shame came over me. And I knew that this was not right.
I didn't like it, and I was sorry for him to do that to me. I wanted my mom to call the cops and them deal with it.
I was a child molester for 32 years. I started molesting other children when I was 5, and I continued to molest children until I was 37. My mother, father, brother, sister, and my wife and children knew I was a molester. But no one wanted to talk about it because they didn't want to believe their son, brother, husband, or father could be a molester. I remember how strong and powerful I felt when I was abusing someone, and they weren't stopping me.
Sexual assault is illegal and punishable by jail for a very important reason. All of us have the right to keep our bodies private, safe, and comfortable. To violate another person's body is wrong, very wrong. Some kids or teen may begin to develop a pattern of sexually assaulting others. If this happens, they have developed a very serious problem, which requires immediate professional help. It is absolutely critical that they learn to understand and admit the seriousness of their actions, that they learn why they are committing the assaults, and that they learn acceptable, non-harmful ways of dealing with their feelings and needs.
I don't believe that a molester can stop without therapy. In 1985, one of my victims told a school counselor that I had molested her. I found out, got an attorney, and turned myself in. What stopped me from being a molester was regaining the memory of my own first molest, remembering the way I felt as a 4-year-old. Once I remembered that, there wasn't any way that I could do that to somebody else. Don't be like me. Find someone who can help you and start changing your life now. Please stop. Don't pass it on.
Not all kids, boys or girls, who have been abused will go on to abuse others. Only a few will act out in that way, but it is such a serious problem when they do. We all need to be aware and do whatever we can to make sure that no more kids are abused. No child or teen should be sexually abused. If you were hurt in this way, if someone touched or violated your body, or forced you to do something with theirs, and now you want to do that to someone else, to see how it feels to be on the other end, the powerful end, we urge you to get some help, to heal your pain, and to understand you didn't deserve what happened to you, and it was not okay for someone to hurt you. And please, please, whatever you do, don't pass it on to another child, because now you know that even one time can hurt for a lifetime.
Don't be a big bully and hurt other kids.
You don't know what you're doing to somebody. It's not just once. It's their whole life. So please, if you've been hurt, I'm sorry. Get help for yourself and don't hurt anybody else.
For kids that have been sexually abused, it's always painful and confusing and upsetting for them. And they do a lot of things and try a lot of different ways to make the hurt go away. Hurting somebody else is never the answer. Kids should never be expected to fix this kind of problem by themselves. They need help. A lot of times the people they expect to help them don't. And kids don't know who else to turn to and they give up. And for a long time, people who cared about us didn't understand sexual abuse and couldn't help us. But now it's different. There's lots of people who care and they do understand. But you have to look for them. You have to reach out. You have to ask for their help. And finding the words is really hard, but you have to keep trying. Many of us have gotten better by helping each other, not by hurting someone else. And that's why we're here, to help. I see a resolution.